Hello, my name is Stefan Dorotich. I'm representing group number 22 from tutorial 5 for Computer Science 233. I'm here to present demo 3 for our group project for the semester. Our group project, the one we decided to create, is an application called Taskilla. It is a task tracking app. It's designed to keep track of users' tasks, allowing them to create new ones, edit them, complete them, as well as delete them. One of our interests at the beginning of the semester was to create something that had some group functionality so you could share tasks between users. We haven't quite gotten that far in implementation just yet. However, we have built it up so that it supports multiple users, each of which can have their own unique tasks and manage them themselves. So let's jump right in and show you how this application works. So first things first, when you load up our app, it brings you to our login menu, which prompts for a username as well as a password. So I can go ahead and enter those fields. If I happen to enter my password incorrectly and I try to log in, it'll just go ahead and tell me that there's an invalid password and highlight that field there in red. Now, if I do this a couple of times, it'll actually pop up with a warning saying that I've had too many password attempts and that if I enter it incorrectly one more time, the program is going to close. So let's go ahead and enter in the correct password. And now I should be ahead and logged in. Good. So once I'm logged in, this is our home menu. It just has a little hello message, as well as it has, in this case, there's two tasks that are currently active for me, these middle two right here. So if you'll notice, these ones are put in order based on their due date. So whichever one is the oldest due date or the earliest due date, that one will be put first and then with everything else following it there. So the main thing that you want to be able to do with the task app is add a task. So let's go ahead and do that. We have this little add button down here. So I can go ahead and click that. This brings us to our add task scene that allows us to input the name, notes, and due date. So let's go ahead and create one here. Drink more coffee, because everybody needs to drink more coffee. Let's go ahead and add that. Oh, okay, I guess I can't add that. I must provide a due date. So let's say that due date is today. The notes are optional. So I can go ahead and create that. And if you'll notice, it has now input that here again in the correct order. So now there's a new task there. Let's go ahead and add another record demo 3, which is what I'm working on right now, complete soon. And then we'll create a due date for tomorrow because that's when it's due. Great. And now if you'll notice, there's only 3 here, but that should have been my 4th. So what happened? Well, we designed our program to only display 3 tasks. We didn't want to overwhelm users when they first log in. So we only want to have the 3 most relevant. But if you do want to see your previous task or all of your tasks, we've got this button here to bring us to our view all screen or display all tasks screen. So here you can actually see all of our active tasks. Now, if we happen to have more, let's say we had 10, there would be a scroll bar that would be here and you could actually scroll through all of those tasks. So from here, there's a few things that we're able to do. So if you notice when I hover, it does change the highlight color of these tasks. So let's go ahead and click on this first one, this implement scene controller class, which I have already completed, and I can go ahead and complete that. Perfect. So that corrects that there. And if I go back to my home menu, you'll see that that is now also completed. Let's go back to that view all. So another thing I can do is if I click on something, I can select it. And this brings me to my task menu, which gives me a few options to complete that task, to edit the task, delete it, as well as it displays the information. So in this case, the first thing it displays is the name of the task, followed by its due date, followed by any notes. And now in this case, this task had no notes, so that's why there's nothing displaying there. But let's go ahead and edit this. I think I might have made a mistake, so I think it should be get an A plus in CompSci 233. Hopefully. I think we can do it. And then I can go ahead and click done. This will just bring us back to the main screen, which you can see now that task has now successfully updated. So a couple of the other things that we can do, up here we have this little profile button. So if I click on it anywhere, it'll bring this little drop down menu that has a couple of options on it. So you can see that there is a logout option that'll bring us back to the login screen. We'll see that in a second. We can also close the app from here. It has the same functionality as if I press this little X button up here to actually close the app. We have this button to send tasks email, to basically send a list of the user's tasks to their email address. Unfortunately, we're having a little bit of difficulty getting that to implement properly because I'm not going to go into details about that here. But I can go to my settings So for our settings, I can actually go ahead and modify my username right here, as well as my user email that I have inputted. So if I go ahead and try this, well, let's try Kareem. He's one of my teammates and actually has an account. So if I click update, it'll tell me that this is actually an invalid username because Kareem already exists. So I have to enter something that is not currently used. Let's go Stefan D, because that's my last name. If I click update, you'll see here that it's actually updated right here in the middle. So from here, I can go ahead and log out. Now, if I try to log in with Stefan, which is my previous credentials, it's going to tell me there's an invalid password because the password doesn't match any account name Stefan. But if I go Stefan D, which is what I updated it to, and go ahead and log in, I can go ahead and log in, and you'll see that all of my information is still saved there, is still in the proper order. It's all there and ready to go. Now, I also have these delete buttons along the side. If there's a task that I did or added erroneously, I can just go ahead and delete that. To be honest, it's pretty late. I really don't need to drink more coffee, so I can just go ahead and delete that. And again, that'll remove it from everything. And when I delete it, it'll also delete it from our save file so that when I log in the future, it won't show up again. So the last bit of functionality that I'd like to go through is how to create a new user. So let's go ahead and log out one more time. In this case, I can create a new user. I can enter a username. Let's go with test. The email address is optional, but let's enter one anyways. And enter password. So well, actually, I guess one thing to notice, let's say I enter two passwords that do not match each other. It'll tell me that the passwords match. And oh, it looks like this username already exists. So let's maybe create test one instead. Perfect. So now that I've created a new user, it immediately brings me to my home screen. And this tells me that I have no tasks because there are in fact no tasks to display. But from here, I can create a new one. And then create a due date, let's say then. And then it works just like normal. Now there's a task here and we are good to go. So from here, I can go ahead and close the app. That's about everything for our functionality. This will of course save everything. So if I close this, I can load everything back up again and it'll work just fine. Now I just want to quickly go into our UML diagram just to look at what is going on here. So our app, one of the primary challenges that we faced here was dealing with a lot of scenes and having to navigate between them. So inside our application class, our application package, we have a bunch of controllers. So we have a controller to control the login screen, to control the home screen, to control the settings screen, the display task screen. So we have a lot of different scenes that we're switching to and from. But to control all of this is our GUI-based app. So this is the one that is the workhorse. It's the one that has instance variables for our user and tasks. And it's the one that's performing all the backend control. One of the things that we did to reduce the amount of code duplication in our project, initially when we were building these scenes, well, each one of these scenes are launching other scenes. So when you click a button, it has to launch this scene. And that was becoming a little bit problematic because we had a lot of code replication because you try to launch the home screen, but that can happen from about five or six different places inside of our app. So you had the same line of code running five or six different places. So what we did to mitigate that was we actually created this thing called a scene controller whose only job is to launch different tasks, or sorry, launch different scenes. It launches a bunch of different scenes. So the way we were able to manage that was create these static calls to these launch methods within our GUI-based app to help us with that code navigation. Now, the rest of our project is separated from the application on this side with our logic classes over here. Okay. Our logic classes have remained mostly unchanged. They are our task class as well as our user class. As well as the collections that control groups or collections of those two types of primary types of objects. We have added a couple new methods that have helped us with this. Primarily, not primarily, but some of the things that we created was a sort and delete method, for our tasks. We really wanted to be able to sort our tasks so that they display it in order by priority. So anything that's really needs to get done shows up first, as opposed to having it in a jumbled order like it was when we first built this project, as well as a delete method that took us a little bit to implement because it had to modify the save file that we have for all this stuff. We also included stuff like validation within our user collection. So this way we could check if a password and username actually existed within our project. So a couple of things that we could improve on that we're still working on. There's a little bit of replication still within our code. So one thing that we noticed here is the cell is repeated and these objects are virtually the same. And one of them is used in the home screen where you see those tasks laid out, and the other one is used within the display tasks scene where all the users' tasks are laid out. So we could probably create a new class just to handle the cells. Oh, there it goes. Another thing that we'd like to do is implement a complete button inside the cells. I don't know if you noticed, but for each one of those task cells, there was a little trash bin to delete it. So maybe beside it, we could include one that allows you to complete it a little bit more accurately. We'd also like to implement a few basic statistics so that when a user logs in, they have a little bit of information about what they've accomplished so far. Because right now, it definitely displays the tasks well, but there's not a whole lot of feedback for the user. So we'd like to create a little bit of stats so that they can know what they've finished and know what they still have to know how much they finished. So a couple of basic statistics like that. Finally, another thing that we need to just verify while we're going through a code is just make sure that there's no logic inside of our scenes, our scene controllers, sorry. So our controller classes really should just be controlling the JavaFX scene that the user is interacting with, but they shouldn't be making any modifications to actual objects. So we have a little bit of bleed here, for instance, with our edit task controller, which actually happens to have an instance of a task because there's a selected task that you can edit. So really that should be migrated into our GUI-based app because the GUI-based app is the one that should be controlling all of our tasks and all of our data from this project. Anyways, that's it for me. So we still have some work to do, but overall we're pretty happy with it. It's looking way cleaner than it was. The navigation is way more smooth. It finally has full functionality. We're still working on that email thing, but other than that, every button works and the navigation is consistent and it's clear and it's obvious. And our save functionality is nice and consistent. We definitely have spent a long time fixing all these little bugs that come up as you're working on these big projects like that. Anyways, for sake of not rambling too long, I'm going to go ahead and call it there. Thanks for listening. We'd love to get some more feedback to see what kinds of things we can improve or maybe some things that we might have missed. Anyways, thanks so much for your time. Cheers.